Hello students, in this video we are going to learn the second part of the lesson ecosystem. Now we will learn about the types of ecosystem. Biosphere consists of different types of ecosystem. Ecosystem is broadly classified into natural ecosystem and artificial or man-made ecosystem. Natural ecosystem is formed with or without human interference, whereas artificial ecosystem is maintained and it is designed by man. Natural ecosystem can be again classified into terrestrial ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystem, example, forest ecosystem, grassland ecosystem and desert ecosystem which lie on the land. Aquatic ecosystem present in the open water. Aquatic ecosystem is classified into freshwater ecosystem and marine ecosystem. Freshwater ecosystem comprises of the lake, pond, ditch, etc., river, lake, pond, river, etc. Freshwater ecosystem is classified into lotic and lentic. Lotic means running water bodies. So the water will run in the river, stream or spring. Whereas lentic ecosystem, it is a standing water body. Lentic ecosystem is present in the standing water body. Example for this is pond and lake. Now the structure of pond ecosystem. It's a very important question. And it is a classical example for natural, aquatic, freshwater, lentic type of ecosystem. So lentic means standing water body ecosystem. So this, by studying this ecosystem, we can understand the structure and function. When the rainwater gathers in the shallow areas, it forms a pond. This we know. And gradually over a period of time, different organisms exist, like microbes, plants, animals, become a part of this ecosystem. And this pond ecosystem is a self-sustaining and self-regulating ecosystem. And it provides a complex interaction between the biotic and abiotic components in it. The abiotic components include the dissolved inorganic components like carbon dioxide, oxygen, calcium, nitrogen, phosphate, etc., and organic substances like amino acid and humic acid. The functions of the ecosystem is regulated by few factors like light, temperature, pH value of water and other climatic conditions. Next, biotic components are classified into producers, consumers and decomposers. What are the producers? Producers are the plants that can produce their food by themselves. Autotrophic. A variety of phytoplanktons like Oscillatoria, Anabaena, Chlamydomonas, algae like Spirogyra, Helothrix, Hydogonium, floating water plants, Azolla, Salvia, Pistia, Nymphia, etc. constitute the producers of a pond ecosystem. Biotic components also comprises of the consumers. Consumers include zooplanktons like Paramecium, Daphnia, which are considered as the primary consumers, and benthos. Benthos are the organisms that live in the bottom of the pond. They are bottom living animals like mollusk and annelids. So they are called benthos. And secondary consumers are the water beetles and the frogs. Tertiary consumers like duck, crane, some top carnivores will include the large fish, hawk and man, etc. So they form the consumers of a pond ecosystem. Decomposers. Decomposers are the microorganisms that help to recycle the nutrients in the ecosystem between the biotic and abiotic components. Example, bacteria, fungi, they help to decompose the dead organic matter as well as all the waste material that are settling in the pond. And enrich the soil and enrich the water, abiotic components of the ecosystem, pond ecosystem. The cycling of the nutrients between the abiotic and biotic components is evident in the pond ecosystem. The cycling of the nutrients between the abiotic as well as the biotic components makes it self-sufficient, makes the pond ecosystem as a self-sufficient and self-regulating ecosystem in nature. Now let us learn the stratification of pond ecosystem. Based on the factors like distance, penetration of light and depth, the pond can be divided into different zones like littoral zones, limnetic zone, profundal zone and benthic zone. The topmost zone is called as littoral zone. It is closer to the shore with very shallow water and this allows easy penetration of the light. It is warm and it is occupied by deep-rooted plant species. The next zone is called as limnetic zone. It refers to the open water with an effective penetration of the sunlight. And here we can see the domination of the planktons. The deeper region of this limnetic zone is the profundal zone. In the profundal zone, there is no effective sunlight. And here we can see the predominance of heterotrophs, heterotrophs of the organism that live on the other organisms and plants. Bottom to this profundal zone is the benthic zone. The bottommost zone of the pond is termed as the benthic zone and it is occupied by the community of organisms called benthos. So benthos means bottom dwellers and they are usually decomposers and mollusks. The productivity of the ecosystem depends on the organisms or the plants that live on the littoral and limnetic zone where there is greater penetration of light that helps for the photosynthesis. What is limnology? It is a study of biological, chemical, physical, geological components of inland freshwater aquatic ecosystem like ponds, lakes, etc. What is oceanography? It is a study of biological, chemical, physical and geological components of oceans. Study of pond, lake is called as limnology and study of sea or ocean is called as oceanography. Plant succession. We can notice a piece of land in a year of different season having different types of plants because they are affected by the natural calamities like hot sun, flood, earthquake and some of the anthropogenic activities like fire, overgrazing and cutting of the trees. So men also cut the trees and destroy all the plants of an area and makes it barren sometime. So due to all these reasons, all the plants of the area are destroyed sometimes and the area become nude. But after some time, after a period of time, we can see the plants arising in that area in nature by itself. So how does this happen? And they will be replaced, these one group of plant which are surviving in one season may be replaced by another type of plant community. And that happens every time of the same area or place. And this is what is called plant succession. So succession is that successive replacement of one type of plant community by another, by other type of the same area or the place. I repeat, what is plant succession? Successive replacement of one type of plant community by another type of plant community of the same area or place. What are pioneers? Pioneers are the first invaded plants in a barren or nude area. So when the nude area, when it is occupied by a group of plant for the first time, then they are called as pioneers. But these pioneers will be replaced by a series of replaced by different types of plant communities season by season, and this happens and they are called as seral communities. What are seral communities? A series of transitional development of the plant communities one after another in the given area. Now what are the characteristic features of ecological succession? So succession causes changes in the specific structure of the plant community. So if we observe a piece of land which is near to our house area, at one season it will be holding some sort of plants and another season it will be replaced by some other plants, and sometime when during the dry season it will be empty or barren. And so there are changes that happens in the specific structure of the plant communities, and it also changes the abiotic as well as the biotic factor in that particular area. It transforms the unstable community into stable community. Sometimes plants are replaced by trees which become stable and which live for many more years in that particular area. And gradual progression in species diversity happens, total biomass, niche specialization, which means whichever organism is comfortable in that particular area will come and occupy and survive in that particular area. So that is what is called as niche specialization. And humus content of the soil can also take place. So there will be gradual change in that particular area of all these matters, like species diversity, total biomass. Sometimes it will be a greater after a rain. We can see large number of plants growing in an area, large number of grasses suddenly arise because of the seeds which are dispersed by various agents. And humus content of the soil also will increase by gradual changes of the specific structure of the plant community. And ecological succession progresses from simple food chain to complex food web. In the beginning stage, there may be the food chain of the organisms may be simple and linear, but after which, when many organisms are attracted or in living in that, when many organisms live in that particular area, it becomes a complex food web. So it will modify the lower and the simple form of life form to a higher life forms, and it creates interdependence of the plants and animals. So these are the characteristic features of the ecological succession. Now the types of succession. First one is primary succession. This happens the development of the plant community on a barren land. Second one is secondary succession, development of the plant community on a disturbed area, somewhat disturbed area. When there are some plants arising, then it is called a secondary succession. Next one is autogenic succession, which is controlled by the biotic components of the ecosystem. Allogenic successions are controlled by the abiotic components of the ecosystem. Next type is called as autotrophic succession. It occurs in the medium that is rich in the inorganic substances. Heterotrophic succession, it occurs in the medium that is rich in organic substances. When the plants are more, when the microorganism and the smaller organisms are more, it will invite other heterotrophic organism to come and live in that particular area, and that is called as heterotrophic succession. Primary succession, this is the development of the plant community in a barren land where there is no plants or organism existed before. The plant which colonized first in the barren land is called as pioneer species or the primary community or the primary colonies. Generally, the primary succession takes a long time to occur in any region. Example, microbes, lichens and mosses. Secondary succession. This is the development of the plant community in an area where there was already a community which has been destroyed by some natural disturbances like fire, flood, human activity, etc. So, in the secondary succession, in the first two years you will have the annual plants. Third and fourth year you may have the grasses and the perennials. 5 to 150 years intermediate species like grasses, shrubs will be grown, and after 150 years the shrubs and trees are present. That becomes the climax community of the secondary succession. Autogenic succession occurs as a result of biotic factors. Vegetation reacts with the environment and modifies its own environment, causing its own replacement by new communities. That is, new types of plants are replaced by the previous type of plants. Example, in a forest ecosystem, large trees produce broader leaves providing shade for the forest floor area. It will affect the shrubs and the herbs which requires more sunlight, which are called as heliopites. So, the small shrubs and herbs will be replaced by large trees. But this will support the shade tolerant plants like xylophytes to grow well. So, heliophytes will be replaced by xylophytes in the autogenic succession. Allogenic succession occurs as a result of abiotic factor. That is, the replacement of the existing community is caused by external factors like soil erosion, leaching, etc., and not by the organisms, existing organism. Example for this is in forest ecosystem, soil erosion and leaching will alter the nutrient content of the soil that will lead to the change of the vegetation in that particular area. Autotrophic succession. If an autotrophic organism like green plants are dominant during the early stage of succession, it is called as autotrophic succession. This occurs in the habitat which is rich in the inorganic substances. Since green plants need large amount of nutrients for their growth and development, autotrophic succession happens in the region where there is which is rich in inorganic substances. Since the green plants are dominating in the autotrophic succession, there is gradual increase in the organic matter and the energy flow of the ecosystem. Next type is called heterotrophic succession. If the heterotrophic organism like bacteria, fungi, actinomycetes and animals are dominant during the early stages, then it is called as heterotrophic succession. This succession will take place when the area is rich in the organic substances. Since heterotrophs dominate this in the beginning of the succession, there will be gradual decrease in the energy content. Now the differences between the primary and the secondary succession. The primary succession take place in a barren land. Secondary succession take place in the disturbed area. Primary succession is initiated due to the biological and any other external factors, whereas secondary succession happens due to external factors only. Primary succession starts when there was no soil itself in that area, but the secondary succession can start where the soil cover is already present. The pioneer species of the primary succession comes from outside environment, whereas the pioneer species may develop from the existing environment in the secondary succession. And primary succession takes more time to complete, whereas the secondary succession comparatively takes less time to complete. Now let us learn the classification of plant succession. Plant succession can be classified into hydrosyre, mesosyre, xerosyre, lithosyre, halosyre and samosyre. Hydrosyre, the term itself tells you that it starts with the region where there is plenty of water. Example, pond, lake, streams, swamps, etc. Mesosyre succession starts in the region where the moisture content is adequate or moderate amount. Xerosyre, the succession starts in the region where the moisture is present with minimal amount of water content. And lithosyre is initiation of the plant community on a barren rock. And hydrosyre, initiation of plant community in the saline water. And samosyre, initiation of plant community on sand region. Now let us learn hydrosyre in detail. So succession in a fresh water. Hydrosyre example, succession in a fresh water pond or lake. First stage, phytoplankton stage. So they are the pioneer community and they include green algae, blue-green algae, diatoms and bacteria. Second stage is the submerged plant stage. Submerged means underwater. So they are totally under the water, inside the water. Example, Cara, Utricularia, Vallisneria, Hydrilla. Third stage is a submerged free-floating plant stage. Some portion of the plant will be under the water and some will be floating on the water. Some plants will be free floating in this stage. Example, Nilembo, Nymphaea, Azolla, Lemna, Ulfia and Pistia. The fourth stage is called as reed swamp stage. It is also called as amphibious stage. During this stage, the rooted floating plants will be replaced by the plants which can live successfully in the aquatic as well as the aerial environment. Example for this is Typha, Phragmites, Sagittaria, etc. The fifth stage is called as marsh meadow stage. Here when the pond becomes shallow due to decrease in the water level, species of Cyperaceae and Poaceae will live in it. Example, Carex, Juncus, Cypress, etc. At the end of the stage, the soil becomes dry. The marshy vegetation disappears gradually and lead to a shrub stage. And so the next stage is the shrub stage. Here, the disappearance of marshy vegetation continues and soil becomes dry. Hence, these areas are now invaded by the terrestrial plants like shrubs. Salix cornus are the example. Trees like populus and ulnus will be growing in during this stage. So accumulation of humus with further rich flora takes place in the sherp stage. The next seventh stage is called as forest stage. It is a climax community of hydrosia. A variety of trees will invade the area and develop. Example, temperate mixed forest like ulmus, acer, quercus and tropical rainforest trees like Artocarpus, Cinnamomum and tropical deciduous forest like bamboo and tectona. In all the seven stages of hydrosia succession, stage 1 occupies the pioneer community, stage 2 to 6 occupies cereal communities, and stage 7 occupies the climax community. So first stage is phytoplankton stage, second submerged plant stage, third stage submerged free floating stage, fourth stage is a reed swamp stage where the water level will start decreasing, becomes shallow. Water level becomes shallow in the marsh meadow stage due to the accumulation of humus. You can see the accumulation of humus at the bottom of the pond. And during the shrub stage, soil becomes totally dry. And last stage is the forest stage. Now, what are the significance of plant succession? Ecologist can access and study the several stages of the plant community found in the particular area. They can analyze and understand the types of plant communities and the type of organism which it can fetch by studying this plant succession. Plant succession also help to understand the controlled growth of one or more species in the forest, by which we can increase the forest area. Utilizing the knowledge of the succession, even dams can be protected by preventing siltation. So the dams which are constructed can be protected with the knowledge of this plant succession. And plant succession is used during reforestation and afforestation. Plant succession, study of plant succession helps in the maintenance of pastures. It helps to maintain the species diversity of an ecosystem. The pattern of the diversity during the successions are influenced by the resource availability and the disturbances by the various factors. So that can be studied and the disturbances can be avoided. So plant succession will involve the colonization of the habitat, a new organism which could adapt to that particular area which is devoid of life can happen through this plant succession. So it involves the colonization of the habitat of an area which is devoid of life, and it also involves the re-establishment of the plant community in the disturbed area and habitat. So even though the area is disturbed, so some other plants which can accommodate the area can come and live in it by the plant succession by itself in nature. Forests and vegetation that we come across all over the world are the results of the plant succession. In nature, the plants and the organism which we see around where there is no human activity is because of the result of the plant succession.